Good evening, everybody, and welcome to another edition of Chasing Rabbits. My name is Scott Brown, and you have found my vlog dedicated to trying to help you become the leader that you always wished that you had worked for. So one of the questions that I get on a pretty regular basis is, what is it that makes a great leader? Are there specific things that leaders do better than others? Are there traits they have? Are there things that are embedded in their personality that make them a better leader? What is it that they do that separates themselves? I'm going to say that there are not specific traits that they have. There are not behavioral markers that they have. There's not anything innate within them that makes them so much of a better leader than anybody else. I think it's what comes out while they are actually leading. I think it's the things that they are willing to do, the behaviors they're willing to undertake, the activities they're willing to do for their followers that make some leaders just more effective and what I would call to be great leaders, whereas others are just leaders. And none of them are really revolutionary. None of them are really, when you hear them, you're not going to be like, oh, I never thought of that. I think they're all, when you think about them, they're all somewhat intuitive. So I think there's four of them. The first one is, I think great leaders have just a natural tendency to want to lean into their values, meaning that they bring their values to life through their actions and their behaviors, that how they spend their time, what they do with their lives. They are focused on specific value-oriented things that are important to them as people. Now, if you know me, you know that one of my great values is helping others find the best in themselves and uncovering that potential and that possibility. I love to be the lamplighter that shows others the way forward, to help walk with others through their journey, to help give them a hand in whatever it is that they're struggling with, to help them go forward. I believe leaders are supposed to be, and part of the great thing in life is we have the opportunity to either be the tide that raises all ships or the tide that sinks them. And I believe in being the tide that raises all ships, never the tide that sinks them. Am I always successful with that? Absolutely not. No way. But that's what I strive to do, and those are my values. When I'm in charge of something, when I'm in a position where I can lead others, or even when I'm creating an opportunity to lead others, I really try to lean into that philosophy, into those values, because I think they help form a tribe and they help demonstrate humility and empathy and create value for those that are willing to follow. So that's number one. Second, which I think is incredibly important, leaders lean into the discomfort of the situation. They are willing to embrace the danger of doing the thing that's uncomfortable to them because they know it's the right thing to do. That means that when there's a difficult conversation, they're willing to have it. When there's a position to take, when they need to take a stand on something, they're willing to take it. They're not always going to do the popular thing, but they're going to do the thing that they believe is the right thing. Those are very separate, and all too often we don't see that in today's society all that much. When you're always willing to embrace the danger, what that means also is that you are willing to fail forward in the pursuit of growth. You know that at times you're going to do something and you're going to fail mightily at it. But you're willing to fail at it because you know it's going to be an opportunity to learn something, that you're going to be able to learn something from that experience to apply to a new group, to a new way. And you're not afraid of the failure, because you believe that failure and success are but mile markers on the journey to wherever you're trying to go. You don't define yourself by your successes, you define yourself by the journey. And if it's difficult, you're willing to take it. If it's easy, you're willing to take it. But you're not afraid of whatever that journey might be. The third thing I think that's really important for all great leaders to be able to demonstrate is trust. And I think there are four components to all trusting relationships. The first is ability. Can an individual do the thing that they say they're going to do? The second is the context. Can they do the thing they say they're going to do in the context of where it's happening? The third is being reliable. Are they willing to do the thing they're going to do, or do they actually do it? And the fourth thing is integrity. Do they do that thing well? Do they complete like they say they're going to? So let me give an example of where those four things kind of really show up. When you think about ability and context and reliability and integrity, I think those things kind of show up in some specific ways. So for instance, I think I do a fantastic job of delivering training. I think I do a great job of communicating. I do a lousy job as a mechanic. So if you were to ask me, hey, can you help me fix my car? I would say no, because I'm sure that if I was going to help you fix your car, you would be walking or taking the bus. That's not something I can do. So I know that within that, there's integrity of me saying no, and that helps build trust. If I was to say yes, I know that I'm not being credible, I'm not being reliable, I'm not being authentic, I'm not displaying integrity, because I'm doing something that I know is going to cause damage. Trust is task specific or situationally specific. Just because you trust someone to do one thing doesn't mean you should trust them to do all things. Everybody has different strengths and weaknesses. How you build trust is by demonstrating what you do well, doing it well, and ensuring that others know why that's important for you to do well. That's the integrity part. So you need, when you're talking about trust, great leaders, I think, really embody those four things. They have the ability to lead. They have the context that they can lead with in whatever context the situation applies. Because not everybody can lead in every context. Different contexts require different skills. Somebody has them, sometimes you don't. So that within the context of whatever the situation is. A third one is definitely, are they reliable? And fourth, do they have the integrity? Those four things I think are really important for leaders. And the last one is, when something goes wrong, are they able to pick themselves up and move forward? Now, what I mean by that is, as you're on your journey, you know that you're going to fail at times. I already talked about this a couple seconds ago. You know you're going to fail if you're pushing forward past your comfort zone, out of the status quo. You're trying to do something different. You have a grand vision for where you're trying to go. Sometimes you're going to push a little bit too far. It's not going to work out. What you do in those moments when you fail says a lot about how you are as a leader. I have not always been good at this, without a doubt. I'm getting much better at it, though. But I've not always been great at this, or even mildly decent at it. There are times I've been absolutely horrid at this. But I think the best leaders consistently are able to pick themselves up when stuff goes wrong. That's why I've spent the past decade working on developing this skill, this weakness I have of making it more of a strength, so it's at least not as glaring of a weakness to pick myself up when something goes wrong, especially when something catastrophic goes wrong. It's what we do in those moments when are inconvenient for our reputation, when we fail, how do you pick ourselves up from that? Now, it's not always, I'm not talking about picking yourself up from like the little things. Like, we should be able to pick ourselves up from just an immediate failure, but if you lose your job, if you get fired, if you lose a friend, if you misspeak and you damage a relationship, what do you do in those moments? How do you ensure that you're not getting stuck in time, reliving that thing, and that you're able to move forward? Great leaders have the ability to do that. When I was in college, it was right about the time that the Buffalo Bills were going to 4 straight Super Bowls and losing 4 straight Super Bowls. I went to college in Clarion, and Jim Kelly lived, his hometown was not far away from us in East Brady, and every once in a while, especially during the summer, I'd run into him at a bar when he would be home visiting his family. And I was always amazed at how enthusiastic he was about having another opportunity to try to prove himself. He was never stuck in last year's loss. He was always optimistic towards next year's chance. And I think that's something great that leaders are able to do. They're able to push forward into something that they know they might fail again, but it doesn't matter because they're willing to take that risk. So I think those are the four traits that really are those four behaviors that I think leaders exhibit on a regular basis. If you don't have them, you can work on developing them. Not everything that we do, we come to the table with. Sometimes we have to invest in ourselves in order to find ourselves. So if you don't have those four behaviors locked up, take some time. Figure out what that looks like for you, and then focus on developing those skills. They're skills that I continue to work on, strengths I continue to try to develop. Am I perfect with this? God, no. Anything but. But I'm a work in progress. and I'm okay with that. So until tomorrow, I wish you well. I hope you have a wonderful night tonight. And tomorrow, I will see you for another edition of Chasing Rabbits. Until that, my friends, toast on, everybody. Toast on.